Madam Deputy, the details of the panel's work is set out in the written report. I shall submit.
Mrs. So Cheung-wing will address the Council on the report of the panel on public service. Mr. So Cheung-wing. Madam Deputy, as Deputy Chair of the panel on public service, I report to this Council the work of the panel this year. In recent years, there's been a widening gap between the civil service establishment and strength, drastic increase in the resignation rate of civil servants, and fewer applications in recruitment exercises. Members were gravely concerned, and members urged the administration to make early recruitment planning and arrangement, streamline the recruitment process, and fill the vacancies as soon as possible to ensure sufficient manpower to serve the public. In order to attract and retain talents, especially great with recruitment difficulties, members suggested that the administration should step up the promotional efforts in recruitment, facilitate Hong Kong students in mainland universities to apply for civil service jobs, legislate to protect public officers, enforcing the laws from being insulted in carrying out their duties, make reasonable civil service pay adjustment, and enhance medical benefits. For example, taking out medical insurance policies for civil servants. At the same time, the administration should review the individual department's overall manpower situation and harness technologies to enhance work efficiency so as to address the heavy workload and boost morale. Members also expressed concern about the continuous increase in the directorate strength in the age group of 50 or above. Members supported the implementation of a new selection and appointment mechanism for senior levels of the civil service, under which vacancies at the directorate ranks could be filled through internal promotion or by open recruitment, so as to widen the pool of candidates for selection for directorate posts requiring more demanding public administration competencies and those with succession difficulties. However, in the long run, members were of the view that succession plans must be devised so that adequate civil servants of suitable caliber can be identified for grooming and training to be successors of the great. On training, members considered it vital for civil servants to acquire an accurate understanding of the Basic Law, the Constitution, the National Security Law, as well as national affairs. The administration should uphold the quality of speakers and trainers, as well as the contents of the relevant programs. The administration should step up liaison with the civil servants in the mainland and increase the training places for senior civil servants on national affairs and key policies. Some members suggested that the administration should provide training opportunities at overseas renowned institutions for civil servants to widen their international horizons. Discipline and conduct are key to ensuring the efficiency of civil service. Members urge the administration to improve the performance management measures in the civil service, draw up key performance indicators, accurately appraise the performance of civil servants, introduce a 360-degree performance appraisal approach, invite public participation in the assessment, expedite the termination of persistent substandard performers, as well as develop a performance-linked pay policy and system. Finally, I thank panel members for their support of the panel in the past year, and also the Secretariat for their support of the panel. I so submit.
Questions.